Welcome all of you to this video. In the previous video, we saw an example based on the area of trapezium. Today, we will see the misconceptions associated with the area of trapezium. Teacher asks Sohan, Sonali and Raghav, if the figure shown is a trapezium, can you find its area? Can you tell whose answer is correct and why? Let's see how Sohan solved this problem. According to him, Sohan took the slant height instead of the height in the formula for the area of trapezium, which is wrong. In the trapezium shown, the slant height is 12 cm. AB and CD are parallel sides whose sum is 36 cm. Substituting the slant heights and putting the sum of the parallel sides in the area of trapezium. In this way, Sohan gets the area of trapezium as 216 square centimeters, which is the wrong answer. Let us now understand Sonali's way. Sonali knew the formula for finding the area of a parallelogram and calculated the area of trapezium using the same formula. In this way, Sonali got the area of trapezium as 180 square centimeters, which is wrong answer. Let us now see the method of Raghav. Raghav used this formula to find the area of trapezium. Then find the values of the required parameters like height and sum of the parallel sides. And substituting in the area of trapezium, he gets the area as 162 square centimeter, which is the correct answer. So today we saw that while finding the area of a trapezium, what can often be false assumptions? Teachers can also test students' understanding in the same way.